Exploring quantum body and beyond, I have been sharing with you some views on language and how language can influence everything from perception to cognition to relationships to creating new models to the evolution of the human universe. And in this context, I've also been saying that human language is quite different from the language of other biological organisms. I mentioned some of these differences before, but let me go further. So, one thing unique about human language is what we call compositionality. Human language can combine simple units, which are words, in infinitely, literally infinitely many ways to create novel and meaningful sentences. Animal communication typically lacks this flexibility, relying on fixed signals or combinations with limited meaning variation. A second feature that distinguishes human language from the language of other species is the following. It's called arbitrariness. The relationship between human words and their meanings is arbitrary, meaning there's no inherent connection between a sound and its corresponding concept. So it's a creation. It's literally a creative linking of a sound and a meaning that we ascribe to an experience. So once again, there's no inherent connection between a sound and its corresponding concept. We create both the sound and we create the concept. Animal signals, on the other hand, often bear some resemblance to the things they represent. For example, a growl being associated with aggression. There's a third feature, displacement. Human language can refer to things beyond the immediate present and also beyond the immediate context, allowing us to talk about the past, future, or abstract concepts. Many animal communication systems are limited just to the here and now. And then, of course, there's grammar. Human languages have complex grammatical rules that govern the order and combination of words. Animal communication typically lacks such formal structure. Okay, now let's look at large language systems and how they work, because I'm trying to weave a theme here. So, large language systems, which are used by AI, are also called LLMs. They are complex AI systems trained on massive amounts of text data. They generate text, translate languages, write different kinds of creative content, and answer questions in a very informative way. They learn and adapt their responses based on new information and interactions. And they perform tasks traditionally requiring human intelligence, like summarizing documents or coding. This is a very significant advance in AI, opening up possibilities, new possibilities for communication, automation, and content creation. Okay, so does language and LLMs now shape our experience and perception of reality? Okay, this is something that has been on my mind forever because I sell words for a living. And also, I think I'm totally in line with the spiritual doctrine. First, there was the word, and the word was made into flesh. So, can language revise our perception and experience of reality? That's the question I'm asking myself, and also exploring. So, think about revised reality as follows. There's something called linguistic relativity. And this theory suggests that language shapes our perception of the world. By providing new frameworks or categories for understanding language, language itself can alter how we experience reality. For example, languages with different spatial systems may lead to different perceptions of space and time. Now we have AI and large language models, which with their vast linguistic capabilities could potentially offer even more diverse ways and novel ways of framing reality. Then, of course, language creates metaphors and narratives. Language is full of metaphors and narratives that shape our understanding of the world. Large language models can generate and analyze these on a massive scale, potentially uncovering new connections and interpretations of reality. Additionally, they could create entirely new narratives that influence our perception of what's possible and not possible. Now, another thing to think about, and this is simulation and virtual reality. The increasing sophistication of simulations in virtual reality could blur the lines between real and perceived experiences. Now, of course, I've always maintained that what we call real experiences are also perceived experiences, and that we are already living in a virtual reality. You know, this is an ancient concept, Maya, that what we perceive through our senses is a superposition on a more fundamental reality, which is pure consciousness or even conditioned consciousness. And therefore, what we are already experiencing is a virtual reality, the world of Maya, the world of illusion, the world of projection, or just call it VR. This body is part of the VR, and this mind is part of the VR, and this whole world is the VR. And now our technology is extending the range of experience of the VR that we're already embedded in. The body, mind, and all objects are actually perceptual activities in pure consciousness, which is the light, let's say the holographic light, if you want to, a metaphor, creating a 3D virtual reality in which we are embedded. And that light of consciousness, awareness, is our fundamental reality. So not only are the lines between virtual and real reality increasing, but we are beginning to understand that the real reality is also a perceived experience in the same way as the virtual reality. So new technologies, often powered by large language models, could offer entirely new realities that we can immerse ourselves in, potentially altering our understanding of the world. So you've heard this expression right now. Everybody's talking about immersive experiences. I did an immersive experience meditation at the future, at the Museum of the Future in Dubai. And so what is a VR immersive experience? You're in it now. We are in an immersive experience right now. So I am convinced that the evolution of technology is part of the evolution of the universe. And it also is the evolution of consciousness and the appearance of the universe as it evolves through the human mind. So it's important to remember that the differences between human language, animal communication, even though they are vast, they have leaky margins, and now there are attempts and human attempts to understand animal language and in fact create hybrid languages that will combine animal sounds with human compositions and ultimately create a world where we might be able to communicate with animals as well. In addition, you know, large language models will present AI technology with the potential to shape and create new perceptions of reality. So I am thinking that we are at a breakthrough point right now with the technologies we have, the languages we can use, and the ideas and shared vision we can have, language, AI, large language models, understanding our connection to the ecosystem of communication in sentient beings could maybe create a new human universe, and could start at least with a more peaceful, just, sustainable, healthier, and joyful world. And then who knows what the limits are beyond the seas of space, both inner space and outer space. The new raw materials of our imagination, and as we create multiple interfaces for cross communication of languages, there are worlds to be created that even Homer never dreamed of. So I wonder what you think of this. Let me know. Quantum Body lays out the framework for expanding our experience of reality, and also for understanding that reality is subject to revision. And who's the producer, the creator, the director, the protagonist, and the villain of this new story? It's us, Homo sapiens.